Hello everyone and welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you are new here, please make sure to hit that subscribe button down below. It means so much. For today's video, I'm going to show you how to make a homemade peppermint lotion recipe. Now, I put this lotion recipe into little jars, and I will link some small jars down below, but you can also put it in a pump jar, and I will link some pump jars down below for you as well. It makes your hands so soft, it smells so good, and this would be a great gift to give to anyone this holiday season. So without further ado, let's just get right into the video. Now, I am making a bulk batch of this recipe, but I will link the exact measurements in the description box below for you. All right, so obviously I'm adding a lot more ingredients because I did this recipe, I think times six, but for a single serving, all you're gonna wanna do is add a half a cup of oil of your choice, either almond or jojoba oil. Sorry if I'm not saying that right, but I added almond oil, a half a cup of almond oil to a bowl, and then you're gonna wanna add a quarter cup of coconut oil to that mixture. Now, I already went ahead and melted all of my oils before I started this video, and I also melted my beeswax here, so you're gonna need a quarter cup of beeswax. Now you can take all of those measurements, and if you haven't melted your ingredients yet, you can just melt it in a pot over a low heat setting on the cooktop, but you wanna just add all of that to your bowl. And then you wanna add 2 tablespoons of mango butter to that. I love mango butter. You can use shea butter or cocoa butter, whichever one you like the best. And then I just mix all of the ingredients really well. Now you can add a different essential oil, but since it is the holiday season and I already put a carrier oil in this mixture, I am gonna add peppermint essential oils. Now I'm gonna add about 30 drops into this batch. Now, for a normal batch like the one that you're probably gonna make, you can add about 10 drops of peppermint essential oil, but since I did make a bigger batch, I added more. And you only wanna add peppermint oil to a mixture, whether it be a bath or a lotion or a detox bath salt. If you add a carrier oil, which is just like an almond oil or a jojoba, I think that's how you say it, jojoba oil, to your mixture. Essential oils should never be added directly to the skin without a carrier oil. It's just not good for you. And then once your essential oil mixture is in your bowl, you want to go ahead and give it one good last stir. And then what I like to do is I like to set that in my refrigerator for 1 hour. So I will see you guys in 1 hour. And then after that 1 hour, I like to take it out, and I just have a handheld mixer, and I like to mix it together for about 5 minutes. Then, after I'm done mixing, I like to go ahead and stick it back into the refrigerator for another hour. And then after that hour, I like to take it out and mix it with my handheld mixer for another 5 minutes. And that is it. And now you can just place it into your jars or, like I said, a lotion pump jar because this is more of like a liquid lotion. Now I do make whipped body butters as well, so let me know in the comment section below if you would like me to do a video on my homemade whipped body butter because that is very decadent. But I just thought, you know, more of a lotion consistency would be nice. And that is it. I'm going to be giving these away for the holiday season. I made these beautiful gift baskets that I gave to friends and family. And stay tuned because I did video my gift baskets for you just to give you some great gift ideas this holiday season. I will be uploading that in a few days, so stay tuned. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please don't forget to subscribe, and until next time, I love you guys so much. Bye!
Thank you. Thank you.